In 2008, Autodesk teamed with architect KlingStubbins and Tocci Building Companies to design its new AEC division headquarters outside of Boston. The project was an opportunity to implement several new trends in the building industry.
We really wanted to bring architects and engineers and contractors together in a different way through a different contract system so that we could create what we thought would be a better building process.
Building information modeling and integrated project delivery are concepts that we believe are going to change the future of the industry. And when we built our own projects, we felt strongly that it was important that we use both of those methodologies because we're advocating their use to our millions of customers around the world.
Both IPD and BIM had a huge positive impact on the Trapelo Road project. We went after this job together with Tocci as a team, architect and CM together.
A conventional project puts silos up around each one of the stakeholders. We have our own risks that are very carefully defined. So even when people want to collaborate, you'll have a good builder, a good architect, they can't really get close.
One of the big differences in working with BIM and IPD is that you've got a shared model. You have shared decision making and you have shared responsibility. It's very hard to blame somebody later on for making a mistake if you were there making the same decision at the same time.
So integrated project delivery is a new organizational idea for how to execute AEC projects, where the owner, the designer, and the constructor collaborate and focus on a set of outcomes that are in the best interest of the project.
Building information modeling is an integrated technical process based on consistent, reliable data. BIM makes IPD possible.
Part of the key to the IPD process is quick decisions that are based on quickly assembling good data to make those quick decisions. So with Revit, we're able to quickly generate detailed criteria to make decisions around.
A good example would be we are cutting a three-story space through the building. When you come in the front door, you're going to be able to look all the way up to the top of the third floor with skylight, light coming down. This was something that was important from a design perspective to really kind of give some wow.
Looking at a few images and looking at the plans, there was some concern that the atrium was not large enough to look substantial or to look elegant. And what we ended up doing was opening the project in Revit, right in the middle of a meeting.
And so being able to really experience it three-dimensionally was very useful in convincing everybody in the room that this was the right thing to do.
In addition to improving our traditional design process, I believe Revit's actually allow us to take some more risks on the design side with confidence that we'll actually be able to pull it off. For the Trapelo project, Autodesk challenged us with developing a LEED Platinum certified commercial interiors project.
The majority of the LEED points are going to come from energy usage. But certainly the materials and finishes and so on that go into it are a big part of it.
And one of the most important, in our opinion, aspects of LEED certification is an attention to daylighting. So we modeled the project three-dimensionally, modeled several options for arrangements of offices and conference rooms and workstations, and then tested those options with tools such as IES and Ecotect. And we were able to explain to Autodesk, with the pluses and minuses of each option, the impact for daylight, and how one of the options, in fact, provided sufficient daylighting for over 90% of the seated positions from natural daylight rather than artificial lighting. And that was used as a decision-making point when deciding between these multiple options.
On this project, because there is a shared building information model, we're able to leverage digital fabrication. The most exciting thing probably is the millwork in the customer briefing center. We were able to take the geometry that they designed and pull that through into the fabricator system so it can go directly into the shop floor of our millwork subcontractor. So the machines automatically cut the pieces according to the designer's model and are then pieced together off-site to be delivered. We have been able to use Revit and Navisworks to plan things virtually and fail on our desktops, start again, rethink it, and do something that works. It enables us to test options and pick the best one.
We can put anything out on the table, and we get instant feedback from the owner and the contractor.
We are intimately involved in the concept creation, and we want to see this project get realized in the best possible way.
We were well coordinated. We have a common strategy for the project. We're able to work very, very quickly with Autodesk, with their staff.
You know, we're helping them be more successful. They're helping us be more successful. That really makes kind of a great story.
So the design, the project delivery approach, and the use of technology all support that sort of underlying theme, which is let's get out there and make the building industry better.
We felt it was really important to put our words into action on our own project. And so Trapelo Road really represents that, really represents our products with the ideas that we think will help shape the industry's future direction.